Aikido's simple. Set up a condition where I'm really strong and he's at a disadvantage. But once you're, come around here, again, in the beginning, don't worry about it too much, but once you start to understand this nice triangle, then from here it's very interesting, unless it's a strong man. But what we have to do is set up a condition where he has to lift my whole body with his elbow. So go ahead. And again, you don't have to be immovable. He's a strong guy. The interesting thing is, I'm not doing anything. All right? Your mats are too soft.
Yes, Sensei.
How's that feel? Yes?
It's fine, Sensei.
Okay, no. Yeah. And again, you don't have to be immovable. You don't have to set up that condition. He has to lift my whole body with his elbow, even with one finger. And if you want to freak us out, then you can do it this way and that way. Again, you don't have to be immovable, but I'm not doing anything. And that's the idea of being relaxed. So from these techniques, you learn how to control yourself. And again, the real thing with martial arts is it's teaching you how to control yourself. And at a higher level, it's learning to control and fix your weak point. Basically, it's right to right. From here, she's grabbing my shoulder. The idea here is she could come here with a hook punch so you can block or whatever. But basically, what we want to do is as she's grabbing here, if she hook punches, you can block. Make sure don't put your hand this way, you'll miss it. Basically, the feeling here. All right? And then from here, as you block, this hand moves to. The hand moves to the shoulder here. Then this hand just goes on the elbow as you turn and drop that way. We'll show you this way so you can see it. It's right to right or left to left, doesn't matter. She grabs, we won't even worry about the punch, but the idea is when someone grabs, this punch is coming. This hand just comes here, if you want, you can do that. Hooking down, and then again, just like a little bit we did, you can turn it over that way. Oh, sorry, oh, that way down. So now I can lock her up with my body being free, so I could snap the neck if you like, but it's better. I won't. But you could do that if you want. Here one, as you go,
what's that?
Am I grabbing you? That doesn't matter, you can grab me, but I wasn't sure. Okay, grab strong, no. Just from here. Get it? It's weird, because it almost shouldn't work. Because we're doing it now, he's grabbing, but now we won't. Just hold your arm strong, strong as you can. How old are you?
30.
30, you have to think? Don't worry. Wait, about 10 more years, you walk into your office and think, what did I come in here for? Oh yeah, my coffee. Good. What did I come in here for? But really strong, you just have to break there. Well, don't die on me, hold it strong. Just there. It doesn't really matter anywhere you get them. And the idea is, you don't need power, you just have to be able to relax. Because if they die, you can just hit them. But there. How's that? And you just take away their power. Alright? Now, I don't know how to explain it, except if you just try to push them, he knows where your power is, he can fight. So you don't give him any power. You just relax. So in Japanese, they call it chikaranuku, which means he grabs my hand really strongly, okay, really strongly, and I just relax my feeling, and then he goes down that way. All right? And then if you can relax, and even these fingers grab both hands. They're strong. What are you laughing at? You come here and try it, come on. It's okay. It doesn't hurt. Grab which finger do you want? Lee, you can pick a finger. This one?
Sure.
No, okay, we'll do this one. Grab strong. Push. Alright? Just from your hips to move it. Alright? Any questions about that? So eventually what happens is you don't have to smash power with power. You can just relax and then they start to feel. How's that?
I feel it.
Yes. Okay? But if I push down this way, it doesn't work. That feeling there. Then it becomes heavy. Alright? Any questions? Now, last little bit. Do you guys know what's called junkenpo?
Yes, I do.
Of course you do. Dunkenpo means rock, paper, scissors. The way we do it is we go Dunkenpo, right? And you, or if you want, you can go 1, 2, 3, right? Scissors beat paper, paper beats rock, rock beats scissors. Okay, make sure, don't do it this way. 1, 2, that's no good. Has to be at the same time, ready? 1, 2, 3, that means he wins. Okay, get your partner.